بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الصلاة والسلام على رسوله الأمين. Brothers and sisters, we have Eid very close to us. And Eid literally means a renewed happiness. It also means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala returned to you with His maghfirah, with His mercy, with His rahmah, with His forgiveness. Right? Now, we're about to celebrate that day. Brothers are wondering, sisters are wondering if it's an obligation or not. If it is a sunnah or if it is a wajib. What is sunnah? What is wajib? What is fard? See, wajib is something that is compulsory but not an obligation yet. Fard means it's an obligation. Now, scholars of Islam have differed about it, that if it's an obligation or not. But one of the opinions that I really liked from the Grand Mufti, the Grand Mufti of Saudi Arabia, he passed away in 1999, I believe. He said, and Sheikh Uthaymeen rahimahullah also, I believe both of these scholars have said in their fatwas, that there is not a single prayer on which Prophet said, bring your women, bring your children, bring the women who even cannot pray. Let them come and listen to the khutbah. He said, which prayer Prophet of Allah said so much about? Which literally means that this has to be an obligatory prayer, because Prophet of Allah commands people to bring people to the Eid prayers. So inshallah, in my humble opinion, inshallah, Eid prayer, whoever can make it, whoever gets time off from work, whoever is not in a situation where he has to see patients in an emergency room or something, must come and pray. Our sisters must attend the Eid khutbah. This is once in a year khutbah that might be the most valuable khutbah of your lifetime. Therefore, choose the masjid where you can understand the imam also, inshallah. And please remember, Eid is not about wearing new clothes. Eid is not about celebrating and dancing that alhamdulillah, I don't have to be hungry anymore. No. إِنَّمَا الْعِيدْ لِمَنْ قَبِلَ اللَّهُ صِيَامَهُ وَقِيَامَهُ لَيْسَ الْعِيدْ لِمَنْ لَبِسَ الْجَدِيدِ Sayyidina Ali radiallahu anhu said that Eid is not about someone who has dressed new clothes and all that. No, it's about someone who Allah has accepted his fasting and his qiyam. May Allah make you and I among those people who Allah will accept our tawbah, our fasting, our qiyam. So make that intention, my brothers and sisters, that this Eid is not just about new clothes. Sure, you should do the new clothes, but what about the Eid's internal meaning? That Allah has come to you with forgiveness and mercy? We want that connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let's make that Eid special Eid. Not a Eid of sinning, not the Eid of haram, not the Eid of displeasing Allah. That's like a hypocrite, that all year I'm saying, Allah, forgive me, forgive me. As soon as Ramadan came, ended, alhamdulillah, let me take off everything and all kufis throw it down. I'm going to the club, I'm going to the party, astaghfirullah. Do you think Allah will accept that? Allah will like that? Allah will say, what a hypocrite this guy was, that all the month he was saying, Allah, I'm all for you. I want to be close to you. I want to be close to you. Huh? And now you're going close to Shaitan. Shaitan will say, welcome, welcome, Habibi. I was waiting for you. Astaghfirullah. I knew you were going to come to me. You will displease Allah and please Shaitan. Think about that, my brothers and sisters. With that note, I want to say happy, happy Eid to all of you. Eid Mubarak to you. Bayram to you. Some Turkish brothers, they say Bayram. Eid Mubarak. Eid Kareem. تقبل الله منا ومنكم كل أعمال الصالحة. May Allah accept all the good deeds that you and I did. And if you have not, may Allah give you and I tawfiq to do more good deeds. There is a big news. 6 days of Shawwal. If you did that fasting with Ramadan after the day of Eid, don't fast Eid because Shaitan is fasting. Second day of Shawwal onwards, 6 days of Shawwal during the whole month, you can do 6 days. Inshallah, it is as if you were fasting your whole life. May Allah make you and I among those people. Wallahu alam.